zu Let's Play X-Men Legends. Really getting sick of these fucking sewer levels. Just saying. But we gotta go through here in order to get to the secret lair of Apocalypse, which Sebastian Shaw gave us the master key for. Now that we've returned all his shit to him. We know his, bottom bitch Celine or whatever her standing is with him. Gotta save her too, I guess. See her down here, maybe. Through here, little storage area where you can smash things up for like health ups, energy packs, money. So if you're hurting for those, might have to fight past a couple enemies to get to them, though.
You should have won the chance.
I know it's been a while since I've had any questions to ask you guys, but I thought of one recently. These guys are physical resistance, why I bring Iceman down here. But yeah, any past X-Men games that you guys might have played, which one was your favorite one? Which one did you like the most and why? Which one would you say you liked a lot and would recommend? Whoops, I thought it was... I crawl for a second. Mine would be the Super Nintendo game. The side with Capcom called X-Men Mutant Apocalypse, based off the 90s TV show. That was really cool. They did I know there was like an unofficial sequel, kind of in that style, based on the War of the Gems storyline, which I would have liked to have seen maybe as an RPG kind of on here, like in this style. Over here, we're going to need a flyer to get over here and grab this little ID card here. Alrighty. Once we got that, head back over here. This time to the left. Oh, we're going to need Magneto for this to push this bus aside. Hop in here for more items to break in a weapons cache.
Yes.
Show that off real quick. Continue on. Got my teleport at the ready. Bugs. I guess the Morlocks are kind of working for Apocalypse. I guess they kind of are in our way. And no, we don't get to run into Marrow again and tell her off or... letting it happen. I don't know. Maybe she got kidnapped and kind of like, well, you're gonna work for me now, and I'll release Marrow, the healer, and all that sort of thing. Like blackmail, basically. But yeah, head to this tunnel, smash through real quick. More smashable shit, and this comic book. More smashables up here. And this way. Oh. Tall and gray, another ambush. I think a lot of these are physical resistant ants. These guys are gonna start falling down through the ladders. Show some on the other side as well. Might have noticed my levels at current is about where I was at the end of the first X-Men Legends. Trust me, it's actually gonna get a little higher. I'm gonna be around the near 50s by the end of it, which is where you probably want to be as well if you're doing this.
Oh, an X-Man. Why, if you aren't a sight for sore eyes.
Sorry, I thought you were an enemy. God, I didn't recognize you without that green and yellow ensemble thing. I didn't recognize you without your Jamaican colors.
Aye. It happened back in the New York pens. Apocalypse's guards are none too kind to their prisoners. Once I've had a chance to heal, you can bet I'll be paying that lot a visit.
You were held prisoner?
Aye. Apocalypse has thrown a great many people into the pens for his DNA testing. And to make matters worse, he's using something called a brain trust to psychically sap their will. It took every last ounce of my strength to escape.
You go get medical attention. We'll take care of the brain trust.
Before I go, let me tell you. I did manage to leave a wee bit of information on the nasties that await you. So keep an eye out for it as you move through the area. Good luck, lads.
Thank you, Banshee. Again, I just saw a dude, like, hanging out. I really didn't recognize it. Even during practice, I keep forgetting that he's you meet him down here so quickly. And again, I know Banshee with that whole, like, really, like, feathered hair with the yellow-green ensemble thing with, like, his wings or whatever. It feels like a product of the 70s or something like that, and it just never updated it, but it's the first time seeing it. Alright, we got all these dudes. That's why teleportation's really great, so I can get through these guys, because again, I'm really looking out for those goddamn goths or whatever that bring them back to life, and they're still down here. Because I can't just use Nightcrawler to get this guy's goddamn it. Especially ones with the double feature. Hey! I killed you. Stay down. Okay. More bugs, these will be easier.
Sometimes I enjoy this.
I fucking ran off. If I got Nightcrawler, cut him off. Okay. We're physical resistant. Taking you punks down. Gotta take my health up. Energy too, but still. There we go. Okay. I think I went the wrong way. Yeah. You might not notice it at first, but there's definitely something down there. I mean, you need to go to the adjacent room over here, or do something about it. Mines! And switch right here, and you'll see it. Boom. Data disk. You'll be able to climb them little small pipes down there. I'll just go grab that real quick and head off into the next area. As soon as I show it off. The holding pens. And she was right about that brain trust. There's something about this place. Feels wrong. Like it's affecting our minds. Controlling my brain, losing the urge to fight. We're gonna pressure on, though. Can't let it get us down. Here we went. Oh! Yeah, they're all down here. Thankfully we're done with the Morlocks though, so these guys shouldn't be too tough to take down as much as they are. That enemy's name was Forsaken. You certainly are for picking a fight with us. It was a Titan! We attacked on it. Don't want to go this way just yet. I wanted to go here, but again, because of all that goddamn enemy placement, I get a little ahead of myself. Another ambush! Taking you punks down!
Please.
No ladders this time, so they don't keep spilling in. And no, Nightcrawler can't port past this, unfortunately, and grab that, as you can see, that final homing beacon. Hey, I grabbed one.
Affirmative.
You. Good now. Please just top everybody off. Okay.
Yes.
Could have just poured it in, I guess. I don't like doing that. It leaves me open to attack. Let the rest of my crew come in normally and do their thing. Okay, this one I have to port through. Then why Nightcrawler is
you are less than formidable.
Again, why Nightcrawler is very good to use for just any situation that requires getting through areas quickly or just getting items. Him being able to do that one attack with zero energy usage is just a bonus. Shame we won't be seeing you again in Ultimate Alliance 1 or 2. You're not playable in either of those. We probably will see you again, but Teleportation will actually go to another character. Some of you might be already familiar with. Oh, that one I could teleport through. Again, you just want to experiment and make sure to... you know what ones you can and ones you can't. And obviously this one's a no-brainer. Just beat the shit out of this machine. Turn that off. Whoop, where'd you come from? It was weird during my first time going through here, because one of these, they were like, infinitely respawn enemies sometimes. I'm just trying to get my bearings. Okay, yeah, this is the right way. Okay. Because this wraps around, and only one side, though, has the items. The second one is just more enemies to kill. Just wanted to make sure I picked the right side. Think over here in the corner, yeah, okay. Whoop, too far. Got that danger room disc. Ford's gonna start selling two danger room discs already. No point in telling you, I would tell you in annotations, but there's no point because we're gonna stumble upon them later, so save your money. We got problems. Oop. Grab you by mistake. A couple more items here out in the open. Another cache there. Yeah, but one of these had, like, areas where those guys would spawn in on them little pads. It was like they would infinitely spawn, so I would be able to get, like, a couple levels here and there and grind a bit. That has not happened here, though. And yeah, no sense going that way, because there's nothing over there for items. Do-do-do-do, I love Potato Girl. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, Ashley Birch-chan. Sorry. Extraction point! Into the next area, the stockade! But before we do that, just remembered we had this unlocked. You know what this is, you know how we do. Now you're about to see why I got these levels up so high. These guys are strong. We fought them before. Mostly the enemies we fought out in the New York part of town. Just a higher level. Funnel them in, just beat them on one by one. Actually, I may not have to, let's see. There's some all over the place down here. Sneaky, sneaky! Just pour it in. Now I gotta break this door, don't I? There we go. Iron Man's jet boots! We now have all... four pieces of the puzzle! I say four because Tony Stark is actually, himself is actually the fifth part. Then we'll have assembled the unstoppable Iron Exodia! Ah! Stark Zodia! It's not possible! No one's been able ever to summon him! Except me, motherfucker. Actually, I technically already did kind of summon him. I did a thing where. Like, if you try to save the game at the end, and I said no, so I wouldn't save over my progress for the final battle. But it asked me to save something else, which turned out to be the, it's weird, like, the levels themselves will still save, but what happened to all my saves now is now it all three unlockable characters are unlocked. Which make things a little weird, but it also makes something a little bit easier, which I can show off later. And I fell through the fucking floor. Hello. Okay, we're fine. Thank God I had Nightcrawler for that. Alright, moving on back to the stockade, where we can finally finish this thing. I got that taken care of. Important here real quick. Switching another Sabbath, you don't need to just grab this body real quick. Not the least I can move through, thank you very much. More dudes. Hi-yah! That's done. There are blue bars over there, but I couldn't port through them. I had to take the stupid long way around and do it like this, and oh! Alright. Another Titan. Speaking of Attack on Titan, Did anyone think that one armored titan at the beginning with, like, the silver hair kind of looked remotely similar to Yashiro from King of Fighters 97? I don't know if that's just me. One of these things we gotta take out quick! Lower the force field. Get these guys. That thing in the middle is one of them traps that actually, instead of stuns your characters, they start to slow your character down considerably. Anyway, we gotta port it down. We can port in here, grab that real quick. Continue on. A lot of more straightforward areas down here, but there's just a lot of items that are tucked away, and I sometimes lose track of them. Haven't missed one so far. This one wraps around. Oh, we're gonna need Magneto for this part. Shove that in. Blows that up, then we can get through here for an item. Sure. Crawl here up. Saw a bunch of dudes in one room. Easy to deal with them. Is that? Turn around before I lose the item. I think it's through here. Because it wraps around first and then it moves on. I see it. Yeah, the weapons cache. And again, you can also port, but you can also just break right on through. That wraps around, but I took the right way. If you took the wrong way, you might have had to fly over here, which probably would have been a bad idea because that ground actually hurts and the rest of them had to like walk through and take unnecessary damage, so it's a good thing I went that way first.
As you wish.
Right. Take this door and get right back to it. Shut that down right away. Here? And over on this side? Oh, I see a data disk. But again, take the long way around. By long way, I mean head here just to lower the force field. Health regeneration. Bro. Grab that. Second of the four data discs for this act. This one should be not that far behind because there's not that much of this act left, honestly. Down. Didn't see what his name was. It said Chilled Master? That's how it belongs to Iceman, because he's the Chilled Master. Yeah. These dudes take down. Oh. Looks like they're guarding a door. Gonna have to break that down and anybody else that gets in our way of door. Said door. To break down, but first, a little side pocket here. Teamwork 403, one of the, that's one of the two, CDs I mentioned the Forge was selling. So, but yeah, keep your money. You're gonna need that to build up your characters like I have. Another one of these to take out. Okay. This man bust through this door as quickly as possible and head through to the Brain Trust. Go on.
Up ahead, you'll be facing not only the Brain Trust, but also a villainous devil named Strife. If you'd like help in defeating them, find the consoles down this hallway. They can be used to deactivate part of the Brain Trust. The catch here is, you need security codes to access the consoles, but I doubt you'll have trouble locating the men who carry those codes.
Banshee knows us well. Thank you, Banshee. Alright.
Yeah.
Yeah, like you said, we don't have to do all these things, but in your best interest, the stuff that comes ahead. Much stronger mutants over here. You can tell by the little X's here. We're gonna go over. Especially some of these dudes that are named. Usually they're just normal ass enemies. That one had a name and also an access code. Hit up these consoles and start breaking them down. Right here is where we can. Using psychic demon creation control. Boom bam. Now we have one. Now we have a friend. Quick weapon cache over here. Still unsettling with the bones there. I guess those are the ones that failed or something? Straightforward area. Yeah, there was like three or four things in this area. I'm just making sure I got all of them. A lot of them say they are just the consoles, though, so. It's just a little weird. Port in, grab that challenge juggernaut. Explain what that does in annotations. What it gets, because it's Sidorak something. Oh shit. Now I'm porting all over the goddamn place. It's actually a bad idea now that I think about it, because I'm making myself lost with this. Anyway, second access code is ours. Trying to chase my steps because there's just a lot of pocket places where shit might be. Brain extract panel with our code Mirin. Take two of those out. Nice. Nope, still gotta take the long way. Son of a bitch! Oh, has he? Wait, how's Joseph say it? Like, son of a bitch! Oh no! My personal favorite. Oh my god! I think it's mostly from the game, I'm not sure. I never did pick it up. You're only level 10, really? Must just stuck you down here by mistake. I'm good. Put in through here. Guys. Get off me. Standing on my shit here. These guys are level 10. And I keep getting fucking stunned. What the hell? I remember them being that hard. Oh, maybe it's that asshole who keeps shooting at me. Now that we have his code, take out another one of his brains. Why can't I port through here? There we go. Damn it.
Sorry, my friend.
A lot of enemies and I'm making myself lost here. Okay. Thing for items and mission targets reads the same on my side here. And that's what it mostly is. There's really only that one item. I think over here's closer in. By the end to both sides of this long ass corridor. Just gonna walk through, not waste any more time. Sure, smash those though, so they stun you. To left and right, two weapons caches. Through here's Strife.
What is such a tiny man doing in my domain? Certainly you haven't come to fight me. Have you come to swear your allegiance to me, little one?
My name's Toad, you git. And you know what I come here to do? I'm gonna give you a major thrashing.
You hurt me? Surely you jest.
I don't mind jesting for Magneto and the Brotherhood, but with you, I'm deadly serious.
I too am serious, Toad. Serious when I say I'm going to inflict as much pain on you as I possibly can. I will destroy you. I will annihilate you. I will utterly crush you into the dirt!
Well, you certainly talk a good fight. I'll give you that.
You fool! Perhaps you aren't aware that in addition to my own abilities, I also have the enormous power of the Brain Trust to call upon.
What the bloody heck is a Brain Trust?
It is a creation of Mr. Sinister's that has a way of psychically calming the prisoners. But it will also aid me in battle.
All right, pretty boy. Maybe you got one on us, and maybe you don't, but we're gonna find out.
Right here, right now. We're gonna need Iceman for this part, because, as he mentioned, the Brain Trust actually helps him out. Every time he gets knocked down, his health goes to zero, these brains will resuscitate him. We already took out half with the controls. Get the other half by keeping far away from them, because if you get close, they have like this little psychic radial attack that pushes you back away from it, so. Maybe you will, because I took you down. Or at least they did. I don't see any other brains, there's no X's. Alright, take two, he's back now, and all the fucking brains are back, so all my hard work undone. Has to fucking stun you as well, just to get more of the fight out. That's bullshit, though! I did it, and you just, like, I guess glitched out because I took him out, like, same time or something like that, and it didn't count for some bullshit reason. Fucking... God damn it! I don't want to target... I'm gonna target Strife, but fuck it, I'm gonna take him out first. Oh wait, that... Oh! So I didn't need to do the brains the second time, I just killed him. Okay!
Seriously, what the
fuck? Well, it's done now! The prisoners are free. Everybody's free. Fuck me.
Way to go, guys. I knew you could do it. Here, let me generate a portal that'll take you to the X-Mansion. Be sure and see Banshee when you get back. He wants to talk to you.
I've never run across that before. Every time I try to record this game.
Hello, X-Man. That was a fine piece of work back there in the New York pens. I don't know if I could have done much better myself.
Considering the fact I had to do it fucking twice!
That was nothing. I'm just glad to be of help in these dark times. That is always a pleasure to talk to an X-Man.
For fuck's sake, man. Where the hell do I gotta go now? I think I gotta use the extraction point to get back to... Where was it? Have it written down somewhere, just because it's all over the place. I have to get back... Extraction from the mansion to the south side of New York and walk from there to the west side, and I'll start the next episode in the north side of New York. Finally try and get even closer to putting an end to all this bullshit. Literally and figuratively. In-game and outside. Next time on Let's Play X-Men Legends.